All right, so in the last video, we created a very, very simple component, and we called it Simple Component, and basically all it does is just put out some text onto the screen. Now, just like with React.js, we can have properties, we can have state, event handling, pretty much anything that we can do in React.js, we can do in React Native. There might just be a couple twists, couple different steps to do it. All right, but as far as properties and state, it works pretty much the same. So let's say we want to pass in a property to this component. So if we go back to index.android.js, and let's say we want to pass in message, and we'll make that say hello world, save that, and then we should be able to go in here and just put right here this dot props dot message, and this should actually be a single curly brace. Okay, we'll save that. Let's reload it, and we get hello world. Okay, so we can insert properties. We can also set default properties. So if we want to do that, we could go above. Let's go above render. I'm just going to tab this over. So right above render, let's say static default props. Set that to an object. Now this red line here, there isn't actually anything wrong. This just has to do with the editor. Visual Studio Code isn't realizing that we're allowed to do this in ES 2015. So don't worry about that. All right, and then what we're going to do is just set message, and we'll set it to hello Brad. All right, so now if we were to save that and reload, we're still going to get hello world because this is the default property, but when we pass a property in, it's overriding it. So if we go ahead and get rid of that completely and save it, we should then get hello Brad. Yep. All right, so that is properties. All right, so what about state? So with state, what we're going to do is create a constructor. And whenever you want to create an initial state using this syntax, using ES 2015, you want to put it in the constructor. All right, and you always want to call the super function before you do anything else, okay, if it's a subcomponent. And then what we'll do is say this.state. And let's say we want show message, and we'll initially set that to true. All right, so we have this key show message and the value of true. Okay, it's in our state. Now, one thing we could do is go down here into render and put in an if statement, and we could say if this.state.showMessage. Okay, if that's true, then we could set message to, and what we'll do is set it to the property, which is hello Brad. So we'll say this.props.message. I'm just going to initialize that here. All right, and then we'll say else, then message will be equal to nothing. All right, and then down here, we'll just replace this with that MSG variable. All right, so let's go ahead and save that and reload. Okay, as you can see, we still get hello Brad. Now, if I were to change the state value here and change it to false and save that, reload, now it's not showing. All right, because we set the property to false, and down here we're saying if show message in the state, if it's true, then show it. If it's not, then it's set to nothing. And we could put anything we want here. We could just say no message. OK. Okay, now we get no message. Now a shorter way to do this would be to go down here. Actually, you know what? Let's just do it right here. So we could say, instead of drawing out that if statement, we could say let message equals this dot state dot show message. Put a question mark here. So if the message is true, or show message is true, then we'll say this dot props dot message else. Okay, the colon represents else. Then we'll say no message. Okay, that's a shorter way to do it, so let's save that. And we still get no message. If I go up here and change it to true, reload. And we should get, oh, this should be message. Let's do that. There we go. So now it's showing our message. So you can see properties and state work pretty much the same way that they do in the standard React.js library. Now, if we wanted to change the state, we could do that. Let's create a function. Okay, so we'll create a function called hide message. And we can say this dot set state. Alright, and we'll set the state of message, or I'm sorry, show message. We'll set that to false. Alright, so we need to call this somewhere. So what we're gonna do is use a lifecycle method called component will mount. So before the component is mounted, this will get called. So this dot hide message. All right, so we'll save that. And if we go ahead and reload, now we get no message. All right. And then one last thing I want to mention is that we can actually have prop types. So for these properties that we pass in, we can set certain types. So to do that, we want to take our class name, which in this case is simple component one, and go down here and we can say simple component one dot prop types, and let's say message, and then react dot prop types dot string. Okay, we want it to be a string. So if we save that and reload, we shouldn't have any difference. But let's say we change this from a string to a number, and we know that it's not a number, it's hello Brad, which is a string. So let's save it and reload. And down here you'll see we get invalid prop message of type string expected number. Okay, so we get this little error message or this warning telling us that that property is the wrong type. All right, so not mandatory, but it's nice and clean to have a little bit of validation for your properties. All right, and nothing here is specific to React Native. This is all included in standard React.js, so if you know React, then you already know all of this stuff here. Alright, so in the next video, we're going to take a look at text input and events. Okay, so when we're using React Native, the events, they work a little different than in React. So we're going to take a look at some of those differences, how to add a text input and catch the value that's being typed in, things like that. Alright, so I will see you in the next video.